this comes from a wind, the Great Lakes Information Network, which gives you, the wind on the whole Great Lakes Basin. But the purpose here is to show you once again high wind speeds here along the lake, in the higher highlands of the Huron Mountains, along the Keweenaw, but also in the Great Lakes, especially in the eastern basin of Lake Superior. There's some really high wind resources. Let's see, where is wind now? Well, there's these orange dots are areas where the Public Service Commission has approved contracts. The one in the UP is in the Garden Peninsula up there. That has presently about 26 megawatts of wind generation being built. They've got plans to go up to about 99 megawatts. Let's see, there's right now approximately 420 megawatts online of generation. There's about another 470 megawatts being built at the moment, and approximately that amount of money, or that amount of generation, has contracts that the Public Service Commission has approved for use towards that renewable portfolio standard that we do have now. What I want to do now is talk through a couple studies that have been done about wind energy in Michigan. The Public Service Commission in 2009 went about a process of looking at where should the state of Michigan try to get or encourage wind development, because the problem that they were seeing is getting wind developed a lot of different places, and what was not happening was a unified plan for getting building the transmission for the wind to get it to load centers, because the way the planning works is someone says, I'm going to put a wind plant here, and then the utilities start planning how to get that energy from here to the load over here. And being wind plants are generally small and dispersed, that's not a very efficient way of doing it. When you know that the peak wind is right here, why don't we just say, okay, you utilities, go figure out how to get connect a bunch of wind generation at that point, as opposed to looking at this small plant this month, then 5 months later, look at this small plant, and then this small plant, because that's just not an efficient way of doing it. So they established the Wind Energy Resource Zone Board to try to come up with resource zones, and they came up with four of them. One in the southwest, one in the Thumb, two up in the northwest of the Lower Peninsula. And those were the areas where they found the most wind and most likely to be built. What they did is they took the whole state, populated it with hypothetical wind turbines, except when they had areas that they excluded, which were roads, streams, the Great Lake shoreline, urban areas. They specified certain setbacks and said, okay, if we've got these wind turbines, how much energy can we produce? So this just shows you a map in this area with the exclusions. So they looked at that and then looked at what the wind would be in these areas and picked the ones that had the highest potential. And they came up, the bottom line was this chart the four wind areas, and if the proposal was to be passed, I would expect a lot of generation in each of those.